No, wait a minute. I have the idea that this video is a little bit messy. Sonja!
Oh no, please!
What I wanted to say, actually... Good morning. The winner will be... Hi everyone, welcome to a new Begeinhoeven video. My name is Tommy, and today it's Wednesday, and I'm on my way to the stable to see what's going on today. And we also will announce the winner of the Equestic saddle clip, so if you want to know if you're the winner, then stay tuned. It finally became summer here. Yeah, the temperature is like already been 22, 3, 4. I really like it. So the horses are outside already with their new fly blanket, which we showed you one or two videos ago, and we must say they worked really well. And we asked the company if you put them in the wash machine, if the coat is still working, like that you don't have to spray your horse, and the answer was yes, so you can wash them and the stuff still stays in. And they're already in the paddock. Isn't that just really nice if you have this view in the morning? Look at this. Isn't that really nice? So the horses are going out with this whole new fly blanket, and it covers most of the horse, pretty much all, except for the legs. So yeah, that's really nice. I am going to check out now on Gert. He made the tech room completely ready. So if you have seen in our previous videos, we moved the horses to the other side. And now finally everything is like settled and on its place. Good morning.
Good morning.
This is a long time ago. How are you?
Fine, fine.
The weather is good, eh?
It's fun to work with that weather.
The fly blankets, are they good?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Fits well.
And they are still in the paddock, so...
Oh, cool. And I thought that you organized the tech room.
Yeah. But now it's a little bit messy.
Oh, fooey. And where did we leave the new products?
I also leave up.
You cleaned up. Oh, we have another secret aisle here. The weather is like, changed a lot. It become very warm. And Gert,
yeah.
Where are you going? He was like sneaking out here. Well, you might have to explain something.
Oh.
Because we do something different according to the feeding schedule when it's hot. What do we do?
We give a little bit of electrolytes to the horses. And now we have the new product from Amers. When it's warm, we give it extra for the horses.
And when do we get started giving it? Because it's important when they're going to sweat a lot that you fill up the electrolytes.
Yeah, if we see when it's getting warmer, we start it 2 days before, and then we give it
all season.
Yeah.
Is there anything we do differently when the temperature's getting warmer, only changing the food? I mean, obviously they can go on the grass now because it's not too wet, so they don't fall anymore in the fields.
Yeah, and we try to put them early out that they don't have to stand in the heat during the day.
With this new fly blanket, do you also feel that they get less warm, or is it not like heat resistant? Because I just looked at it, it felt
okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Now. Oh. Good to know, guys. I told you in the earlier videos that we give our review, so we did. It working really well, and you don't have to spray them, man.
No.
I mean, I just watched them, and they really are not surrounded with flies and stuff. So, good product. And there we have Sonja.
Oh no, please. Don't let anyone see I'm working.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Yeah, warm.
Warm, but I know you're always very happy when the sun is shining.
Yes.
So don't going to complain now that it's warm, eh?
Oh, I won't.
Okay, good.
Bye.
Bye. Oh, look at you. This is also a nice horse. You probably don't know him yet, but he is... Gert is laughing at me. Why?
Yeah, you want to film and Sonja is...
Yeah, I want...
Out, like,
she's like going to mock out. Maybe I have to show you this, guys. Maybe you haven't seen it yet, how it works. Because it's kind of interesting. It only makes a lot of noise. This is our mocking system. It works quite easy, but it makes a lot of noise. So what I wanted to say, actually, is that you guys probably don't know this handsome guy. Hello. No, wait a minute.
Speak about handsome guy and all of a sudden I see this face coming
up. About me.
Hi, Philip, how are you?
Hi, Tommy. I'm good, fine, thank you.
Super. What are you doing?
I'm putting crystal on the field outside.
To the field?
Yes.
Ah, okay. Take four. I'm going to try to explain who this handsome guy is. And his name is Nero. And he is a son of Fanatiek. You probably all know from all the videos with the how-tos and stuff, and he's just 3 years old, and in the next video I'm probably going to show how he moves and how he is, because he's really nice. He has a really nice character, and the plan is that I'm going to ride him in the future. Welcome. I have the idea that this video is a little bit messy. It's kind of those days where nothing really goes as you planned. It goes like it's being all messy. But before I forget, I need to announce the winner of the Equestic saddle clip. The winner will be... She's from Russia and her name is Lisa. She rides with the juniors and she sent me an email. Like a lot of guys did, but I'm only able to give one saddle clip for free. But if you still would like to have a clip, then I spoke to the owner and he told me that if there are people more interested, they can buy it with a discount, and then you can have the code from the Begrijnhoeven, and I will put it here. So if you use that code, you can buy the clip with a discount, so that's also pretty awesome. So congratulations, Lisa. We also received a really nice box with new stuff from Le Mieux, and I'm going to find my husband because he ran away. And Sonja and Gert always laughing. I told you this is going to be very messy, this video. Where is Rob?
Gone.
I will try to find him. Okay, after 1 hour looking, I finally found him. Of course, he was at the coffee machine.
How hard can it be?
Good morning, honey.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm regaining strength.
So I just told the winner.
The winner
of the Equestic clip.
Equestic clip.
So?
Congratulations.
And we also have some pretty awesome new stuff.
Do I show you the shop again? No, actually, okay, this was... Oh, we didn't talk about it, but I will show you because it's actually quite interesting. Christy is our dentist and she also sponsored us with bridles. And you know, Heros is really sensitive with, he had the head shaking last year and it was really sensitive behind his ears. So they sent us this headpiece, how do you call it? This piece. oh, it's actually like this. I always put it a different way. It's like this. So this is really soft at the Atlas. It's Atlas. Atlas. The Atlas. so you have less pressure and it's very good anatomically designed. So I'm really curious how this turns out to be, but it looks really good and it feels really soft.
First coffee.
Yeah. Well, so Lemieux sent us a huge box of cool stuff. Lemieux wanted to do something with our channel. And we love that brand because, as I said the last time, we love innovative products. And we think Lemieux is always, renewing himself, and they're a very nice product. So we asked for a few products, especially for the shows. So what did we get?
Boots.
But I don't know what kind of boots these are, actually.
For the legs.
No shit. That's what's for the tail.
Boots. Hey, this one. Oh, your favorite.
These look really promising because they're breathable and they're easy to clean. So I think they're really good. We got them in a few sizes because our pony Genesis needs a lot. And my decent horses need food. Okay. And what I'm really excited about, and actually, as you can see, we use it a lot. This saddle pad of Lemieux, and it's a very good it's
good
a very
morning.
Good I mean, these are now 1.5-2 years old and they can still be used really well. They stay really good in the wash machine. They even go in the dryer sometimes. Not
I don't know.
We have a dry room, so they go in the dry room anyway. And we asked for a new pad. And we got new colors. So, this is really cool. It's like navy blue. And I really like this part where you put the girth, that it's extra solid. And, it's bamboo even. So we use these for a long time already, but we like them, but I don't know
why you like it.
What's the special thing about these pads, actually, to be honest. But now I read, they're breathable, antibacterial, and the moisture goes out. So it goes to the outside of the surface, so not on the inside, that the horses stay wet. Often described as having the strength of steel with softness of cotton. And of course, we have to have. Where is it? Oh, here. Matching bandages.
We only ride with bandages if we want to make nice photos or videos, because
it's actually for show. We want the boots to breathe. And I think it's really nice when you have clients or when we have pictures or when you just want to show your horse. Then we use bandages, but actually, to be really honest, we use the boots like these, but they're not in white, to train, because I think it's just better for the horse's legs. But this is really nice for showing your horse.
Very good.
We even got a card.
Read it.
Yeah. Dear Begijnhoeve, Rob and Tommy, I have to translate because it's in Dutch. We wish you lots of fun with the new stuff and we love to hear how you like it. Team Lemieux from Lemieux Benelux.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks.
My little pony.
You haven't seen much riding in the last few videos, so we were thinking, what would you guys like? We want to do a few how-to videos again. What would you think would be interesting? So then we can make a video and we make something you like. Of course, many things happen anyway here. We had some baby news. Did we tell you about the Zachary cult? Very nice. We have a very nice Zachary cult out of Fetini again. He's still a great breeding mare. Very, very cool cult. So I'm really happy about that. But we also did not get the greatest news yesterday, or really sad news actually. We expected the seventh foal last night, and the foal passed away, unfortunately, during labor. Everything, he was really healthy. It was a beautiful colt from Finch Hatton out of Gotango, our Contango mare. Beautiful colt, but we still don't know what happened, because his heart was bleeding, and the guy arranging everything there was there and doing everything he could, but somehow he didn't start breeding, and the foal didn't make it, unfortunately. So we have a dead foal this year, and we had a dead foal last year as well, so that's not so nice. Or not so nice, it's actually really sad. But we have to stay positive, and a few more are coming up, and we hope we have enough bad luck with the babies this year again. So we hope the rest will be really healthy and great. In next week's video, we have some big news coming up about the project here in Postel. So you really should not forget to watch next week's video. This was the end of this video. I hope you like it. If you do, leave a thumbs up or a comment, and don't forget to subscribe. See you!